In today's quick tip, let me show you how to add watermarks to your art. Let's get started. A watermark is a semi-transparent design or a text, usually embedded on a digital illustration, a painting, a graphic design, or a photograph. The text or design can be repeated multiple times all across the digital work, or it can be isolated on one specific side. If you see a repeated text all across an image, it is usually done to protect it from being downloaded and used without the permission of the artist. Think about it as a copyright protection, as it helps the artist claim ownership. A watermark can also be used for branding, and in this case, it will appear more opaque to stand out. The text or design, this time, will only appear once. It's like a signature. It can be the name of the artist, the name of a company, or a logo. Make sure that the layer of your image is activated. Go to Filter. Choose the Start Gimmick. In the search bar, type water. Every filter that contains the word water will appear. Choose Visible Watermark. Type your brand name in the top input box. I'm going to go through all the different sliders one at a time. As you will see, all sliders are very easy to use. Using the opacity slider, you are going to make the text appear semi-transparent. Use the next slider to modify the size. Here you can change the angle of the text. To make the edges of the text look blurry, almost out of focus, use the smoothness slider. Finally, if you open this drop-down menu, you can choose how you want your text to look like. Dark or light. When you are done, click OK. Let's say that you are not happy with the size of your text and want to change it. First, undo the filter by clicking Ctrl-Z. Go back to the gimmick filter. It will reopen where you left off. The only thing you need to do is modify the size again. Click OK when finished. I want you to develop the habit of saving twice. Always, always, always save all your projects as a KRITA file first. Then save your work using other formats like JPEG or PNG. Please do not make the mistake of saving your work only as a JPEG or PNG. These file formats were not designed for editing purposes. They were designed for sharing purposes. What they do is create a small size file by flattening the image into a single layer, meaning you cannot edit your image anymore. You will have to start from scratch. The KRITA file format stores everything you've done, including layers, masks, filters, blending modes, etc., etc. When you save your work in this file format, not only it allows you to revisit your project at any time, but most importantly, it allows you to modify your work without starting from scratch. So please, always remember this, save all your projects first as a KRITA file and then save them as a JPEG or PNG file. So we are done. Thank you again for watching and I will see you next time. Au revoir et à bientôt.